are, day four. This is Ebbets Pass, Highway 4. I found the little ice chest that the trail angels left, but there wasn't anything in it. So anyway, I got a late start today, not till 11, but it's a real short day, so I'm just taking my time, stopping a lot because I have blisters, but I took real good care of them yesterday, so it only hurts when I walk. Just a nice day. See my little dear friend? Hello! Hello! I'm not moving. It's okay. Here's the little pond I decided to stay at tonight. I started to get really confused, unsure of where I wanted to go. And I didn't want to continue on for miles and miles. And some PCT hikers told me that there wasn't any water ahead, so I decided to stay here. There are lots of little tadpoles and water snakes. Do you know how much I love water snakes? So last night at Upper Kenny Lake, there was people camped there, and I heard like wind chimes, like those hollow bamboo wooden wind chimes, and I thought it was just me. It was windy. Who knows what I heard. But it was definitely, definitely some sort of wind chime thing. And coming from over where they were, but not right where they were. So I'm thinking that they hung their food away from the bears, but also put some sort of wind chimey thing on it, which is not a bad idea, but a little annoying. But now I swear I hear them again. I don't know if those people were coming my way or not. I might just be going crazy now. As long as it wasn't Mr. Bear trying to get my food. That is my food. And he cannot have it. So. Good night. So scared. I heard a noise. And I don't know what it was. It was a thumping, stumbling noise. Perhaps it's the chupacabra. Oh God. Oh. Actually, no. I grabbed my big ass knife, my really bright flashlight, and I opened the tent. It's just a really clumsy deer. But it's kind of nice to know that some noises are not just in my head. That deer needs to be a little bit more stealth. So, it's 12 o'clock in the morning, and I woke up because every time I rolled over, my heel, one of the blisters, just hurt so bad. It was throbbing, so I took a look at it, and it was pretty red and inflamed, but not horrible. So, instead of keeping it dry, I scrubbed it with iodine and stuck some ointment on it, antibacterial ointment, and massaged my calves. Out of all my muscles, my calves are the worst. They're just these tight little angry balls of muscle. So I massaged those and took an ibuprofen. They feel a lot better. And now my heel doesn't hurt at all. It even looks better. So I'll just have to keep an eye on that. And I think tomorrow, I'll just make another short day. I can do that without getting behind. So I just gotta take care of my feet. My legs and my feet. That's the most important part. So, day 5, and it's raining. I've never backpacked in the rain before. It's not bad though, and actually, it looks lighter over there, so I think it's gonna move on. My blisters are better. No worse than yesterday, but they were worse last night, so when I took care of them, they feel a lot better. My calves feel awesome. It's amazing what a massage will do. So, yeah, 10 mile day, 12 at the most. Getting a late start, but that's okay. As long as it doesn't thunder and lightning. I hate thunder and lightning, and I forgot my hot cocoa, and that's the only thing that makes me feel better. But I still have Jack Daniels. Well, this isn't very encouraging. I'm not sure what this is. It's got a huge shoulder blade. And look at that vertebrae. That's wild. The rain's kind of letting up a little bit. It's just sprinkling. I just find once I'm in the trees. I can't even describe to you how good it smells out here. That's a cool mirage. That's not a pond. That's actually tons of flowers surrounded by all those yellow flowers. This is called Boulder Peak. I don't know why. Boulder Peak. I don't get it. Eh? You're gonna take a bulldozer and bring all these rocks up here just so they can call it Boulder Peak? Place where I can build a little campfire. The mosquitoes away. Hello. So it is the end of the sixth day, and I couldn't really film anything yesterday because my batteries died and it was cloudy and rainy and I didn't have sunshine to charge them. So I got them partially charged today, but I didn't do much of anything today. I was considering taking a whole day off because yesterday I did way too many miles, didn't eat enough, and I was just suffering at the end. And my feet, they're not worse, but at the end of the day, the blisters are just, they hurt more because I'm tired. And so I considered taking a day off, but I did a half day. I did about 5 miles. I'm now almost at the summit, or the Sonora Pass. So I'm having my chicken teriyaki with rice and enjoying my dinner view. And now my battery's gonna die again. Anyway, tomorrow's a big day. Tomorrow I'm going to go over Sonora Pass and keep going. I've never gone that far before. So tomorrow's a very exciting day, very big day, triumphant day. I'm very glad and excited to be here and be doing so well, and I'm gonna keep going. That makes me very happy.